I just want to say one word to you. Just one word.
Yes, sir.
Are you listening?
Yes, I am.
Plastics.
Exactly. How do you mean?
There's a great future in plastics. Think about it. Will you think about it?
Yes, I will.
I've said. That's a deal.
Okay. Coming up to Nimisila Reservoir. Nimisila Reservoir, I believe, was built during the WPA program back in the 30s as a body of water for the local communities. I used to do a fair amount of fishing on Nimisila Lake when, a number of years ago. I really don't fish anymore. In fact, there's a lot of things I don't do anymore. I don't know if it's age or just the fact that you're so busy. Kids in college and other things. It just you only have so many hours in the day. There's a little bit of what appears to be, I would assume, a road salt. So I take it, I throttle it back a little bit because that road salt acts like sand. And it does, I think it affects the adhesion of the tires on the road a little bit. So common sense dictates that you cut back on your speed a little bit. Another nice day, about 10 degrees cooler than it was yesterday when I took the prior video. Again, more shots of the reservoir. Thank you. I had a deer somewhere down through here, a deer ran alongside me when I was going the other way, and I was just waiting for that deer to cut across in front of me, but it went back into the woods. So you got to watch, November when they're the rutting season of the deer. You got to be careful riding. This ice cream stand to the right has really, really good soft serve, or what I call custard. Okay, we're gonna go ahead and make a left here. Heading south back into the sun. There's a jet from the Akron Kent Airport. We're about 3 miles from Runway 11. I took my flying lessons out of Akron Canton Airport. And one day, about 11, 12 years ago, I was taking a lesson. And President Clinton, Air Force One, was at the Akron Canton Airport. So I saw Air Force One on the tarmac, and I asked my instructor, I said, are we going out for a lesson? He said, sure, no problem. So we got in that little Cessna 150 two-seater, and I got to taxi right by Air Force One. That's something you could probably never do today. This was all pre-9/11. And his whole ground crew was on the bottom of that, or to the bottom of the plane, standing. Very impressive. Another plane I was impressed with was, we have the PGA, Firestone Tournament Champions, PGA pro golfers come in. One day I was flying and I see this Falcon, which is a big, it's basically, it looks like a bloated Learjet. I see this Falcon with GN on the tail section. So I wondered, what's GN? Well, it was, found out it was later, was Greg Norman's private jet. Just to operate that jet, the expenses every year were $1 million. So it takes some serious money to own these, anything from a Lear to Falcon, any Citation. It takes a lot of money, and with fuel costs, it's an expense I surely wouldn't want. Okay, I just wanted to show you the scoot at night. First of all, the function of the remote. I'm gonna go ahead and start it up with the remote control. Those are the keys. Just some of the lights I have on the scoot. Okay, I have four speakers. Amplifier. Now I'm going to go ahead and turn on the stereo. Come on!